Hello traders, it's Thursday, November 1st, 2012, and we're going to be looking at a potential bottoming pattern going on in RIMM. This is a 5-year weekly chart, and RIMM has not seen a good run in those 5 years. The top was around 141, we're currently trading at $8.03. So definitely a dog of a stock, but there are signs of a potential basin break pattern that you can play on a shorter term basis, 1 month instead of 1 year. I'm not going to try and call the bottom. It's just a potential bottom, okay? Just, for a little pop. So we have this downtrend line on a logarithmic chart, and we broke above this downtrend line right after earnings, I believe, is on the 1st of, the 1st of October, give or take. So we had a nice little pop on earnings. It got faded a little bit. But what we have more importantly here is this nice, simple horizontal line, okay, where we found sellers in the past few months. If RIMM can break and hold, it's about 850, then that is a signal for a shorter term trend reversal. Now, this is not to say that we're headed to 140 anytime soon. You know, the business model of RIMM and just how they've executed continues to be a problem on the fundamental side. But we can figure out some decent targets for this. Before we really broke down and started into this trading range, the last level of resistance that we saw was around $11. Okay, and that was from the June highs before it really, really started to break down. Okay. So that would be a reasonable level to expect, okay? Another thing you can look at is a declining 200-day moving average right near that $11 level, okay? And that may also be a level of resistance and also a potential price target. One more thing you could look at, this is a derivative of a head and shoulders bottom, an inverse head and shoulders bottom, and we can measure price targets by looking at the height of the pattern and just adding it onto the neckline. Okay, and that would put us also around $11. So that's an expected, 2.5 point move on an $8 stock. That's a pretty decent percentage gain. Okay, a few things need to go right. Obviously, we need to. I'm looking as long as 740 holds on RIMM, then it should be a pretty decent trade. On top of that, we broke above a shorter term trend line that I was watching, where 850 may act as a magnet right here, and we may find some resistance at 850, see a slight pullback. As long as we hold above 740, it should be fine, and then we may see some renewed buying interest going into $9, maybe $10. So there's a couple different ways to structure your risk. IW premium subs put on a call diagonal today. I don't think buying calls straight up is necessarily the best idea. You may want to look at maybe put sales, maybe covered calls, maybe something that, as we head into $10 or $11, you start to gain some positive theta. I think that's a pretty good way to structure your risk. If you like this idea, check out my service at investingwithoptions.com. You guys have a great day.